to what you've got happening
right
now.
All right, I'm going
to
get busy if I may.
Okay.
Now, as I mentioned earlier, we've been looking at an amazing document for the past few days. George brought it into us, and tonight, Dr. Elvin Montgomery has joined us. Now, he holds a PhD from Columbia University, and he consults, writes, and speaks on topics related to history and collecting, and is an expert in African American history. So let me slide right in here. John Bruno has joined us. First of all, George, nice to see you, sir. Thanks for stopping in.
You're welcome.
You know, you have totally changed our show, because this has been going on for several days. We hadn't planned on it, and we're glad you're here.
Thank you.
Dr. Elvin Montgomery, sir, it is a pleasure to see you.
Oh, I'm honored to be here.
Thanks for coming in on short notice like this.
Sure.
All right, now here's the document. You finally had a chance to look at it firsthand. And what I want to ask you about is, when you first look at this, there are certain clues that you look at to get certain information.
Mm-hmm.
Let me start with just something as simple as the blanks right here. What does that tell you, Doctor?
Well, first of all, it tells me it is a form that was pre-printed and was filled in as the circumstances dictated.
So that would mean that maybe it's not one of a kind.
We do not know. On the other hand, it is a charter document, and charter documents are much rarer than other forms of organizational material, for example, membership documents. So though there may be other charter documents out there, this is definitely one of the very few that is in the open market.
Aha. Uh-huh. Now, as we go on to talk more about this, the history behind this document and the clues that are behind this document, the words bounty and pension means
very important, very important. They suggest to me a connection between the persons in this organization and some form of government service. The primary forms of government service at that point for African Americans were probably military. So it means that some of the persons in this organization may well have been ex-soldiers, which gives this document a Civil War connection, which greatly impacts on its value and its historicity.
Now, historically, what else do we know about this document? What else can you tell us?
Well, first of all, the key word ex-slaves here tells you who the constituency of this organization was. It also says that there was an organized effort, a widespread organized effort, even in small towns, such as this town, Smithfield, in Isle of Wight, Virginia, to do something about compensating ex-slaves. The word bounty implies that some of these people in pension may have had a military background, and it is a charter document, which means there was a larger organization that issued this to a local branch or local chapter.
So this doesn't sound like then the organization that introduced this as a bill, but it sounds like a piece of paper that got together a smaller group in a smaller town.
This sounds like those persons who organized themselves on behalf of this issue and were actively pressing by recruiting members who had a personal interest.
Uh-huh.
This is very, very important historically, because it means a bill affects people, but this is the people themselves organizing on their own behalf. And therefore, there are great historical implications to that which need to be further researched.
Different types of historical value on an item like this, are there not?
Sure. You have a number of different types of historical value. There's celebrity value, and there's also the issue value.
Right.
From the point of view of the issue, this is of utmost importance to African Americans, and even it appears today to all Americans, the issue of compensating persons who have been unjustly treated and who have not been fairly compensated in the past. It also shows that even in small town America, on a widespread basis, this issue had not died decades after the Civil War.
Okay.
There's a lot of historical implication to that.
George, are you following any of this?
Yes, I am.
You with us? Okay.
Very good.
How do you go about researching this further? Because that sounds like what needs to be done.
Absolutely. First of all, there are major repositories, such as those at the historical repositories, such as those at the African American colleges. The Library of Congress has major resources for researching old American documents. Secondly, there are historical resources that are now brought into our reach by technology. For example, the records of the U.S. Colored Troops are now available on CD-ROM. Some of these gentlemen who are referred to in the document may have been ex-soldiers. That's one quick way of finding out about it.
Okay, so listening to what you're saying, there's incredible historical significance behind this.
Absolutely.
It doesn't look like it's leading us in the direction of this being a one of a kind. It looks like there might have been others that we
Good
don't
question.
Know about.
Good question. We're not sure. We know that others were probably created, because this is a form, and the form was created to be filled in on a number of circumstances.
Okay.
What we do not know is how many others survived. And that is what remains to be researched. If all the others are no longer available, or if they are available in an institution somewhere and this is the only one in circulation in the open market, that would greatly increase its value to sellers and buyers.
What's it worth?
Good question. Well, at first I thought somewhere between the 4 and 5 figures. At first, my opinion was something like, let's say, 5 to 7,000, ranging up to about 15. However, if it turns out that there are no other documents like this, and certainly not in circulation, and if the circumstances of the purchase were competitive, that is to say at an auction, it could well go for triple that amount. That is to say, well into the 5 figures.
Okay, last but not least, and quickly, excuse me, John Bruno, where does George go next with this document?
The first thing I would do if I were him is to have it researched, is to call up the Library of Congress and some of the major black college libraries to find out whether any information on this organization exists.
Okay, all right.
That is the first step.
George, I want to thank you for hanging in there with us. There's still a mystery to be solved and a lot more research to do. We'll certainly help you with that as best we can, and we wish you good luck on your journey.
But it is well worth it.
It is well worth it.
There is nothing more important than finding out more about this document.
You know, I have to say this. What's really happening here, and very few people get to see this, is the actual appraisal process. This is what we do, is call on experts like Dr. Montgomery, talk it out, go to these organizations, go to the repositories of knowledge, and dig it out. Nobody has this in their heads.
Sure.
You have to actually dig. This is groundwork research. This is what appraising is all about.
And there's one more factor I might point out. For a document of this age and this importance, it's in very good condition.
Okay.
There was only one minor damage. It's here in the margin. Yeah. And the organization spent a little money at the printers because they had it made up very well, very attractively, with a lot of decoration. Yeah. All of that adds considerably to the value.
When you figure this out, will you let me know?
I sure will.
Because I'm not going to be sleeping tonight. George, thanks for being here tonight.
You're very welcome.
And Dr. Montgomery, thank you, sir, very much.
It's a pleasure.
All right. Okay. Folks, don't go anywhere, because when we come back, find out the stories.